Hey everybody, how you doing out there? It's yours, David, truly coming back to another video, another episode of me. How you guys like me now, eh? We're back. I'm raring to go. Anyway, Hollywood is doing a protest right now. All the movie stars out there are doing the Hollywood thing. I'm glad you're joining with me, and it's just a protest everywhere you go in this world. Protests here, there. Canadian to the United States, to Mexico, to China, protest everywhere. Yes, folks, we're protesting everywhere. Hashtag protesting. Yes, if you live in the United States, you have a First Amendment right to dissemble a big, huge rally. You could do that if you wanted to. It's up to you guys. But it's been festering for years and years and years, ever since the Rodney King, from way back in the early 90s. So it's been coming up to this point in the year 2020. Everything is going to change it here on out. I don't know what that change is. People are always talking about every election is going to be a change. Change in the leadership, change in the weathering, the change in everything. Everything is going to be changed around here. It's always change, another change in the world. But I'm going to issue a challenge to you guys, really going to issue you guys a challenge for the whole world. If you can make that change, what would it be? What would it be to make that change? What would make everybody take notice? What would that change be if everybody took notice of that change? What do we have to do? Do I have to look great, look smarter, look decent? Got to get the better leaders of the world? Senators, leaders, Joe Biden, maybe just Joe Biden, just a hint on that. By the way, my view on Joe Biden is a 50-50 chance that he will win in the elections coming up in November 3rd. November 3rd is the elections in the United States. No matter if there's coronavirus or not. Elections, mark it on your calendar, November 3rd. Until then, you people can do a lot of things out there in the world. But November 3rd will become election. Joe Biden is going to got a my estimation for him to win would be a 50-50 chance for him to win. 50-50 chance of him going to win. For this presidency. He was on today, of all things. He was talking about a whole bunch of things. But Joe Biden, he's going to run for presidency. The President of the United States. He's going to run for President of the United States. Yes, you heard it here first. He was Vice President now. And his resume is going to say, Joe Biden, the President of the United States. Yes. Now there's a 50-50 chance that he'll become the President of the United States. 50-50 chance on the night of the election night, 50-50 chance he's going to win. My odds are going to be 50-50 that he's going to win. To be President of the United States, kick Donald Trump to the curb. That's definitely what they're going to do. Kick Donald Trump to the curb. He's a four-year president, one term. That's all I'm going to say, folks. One term president. We're going to have Joe Biden in there. No question about it. But it'll be an uphill battle for Joe Biden. This lady, so-called Tara Reid. You guys can look it up. Tara Reid is this young lady who is accusing, get this, is accusing Joe Biden of, I forget now, but accusing Joe Biden, well, anyways, sexual innuendos, shall we say. Some bad things that happened in the early 90s. Joe Biden has admitted publicly, I kid you not, admitted publicly that he did not. He did not. This is his words. I'm not putting words to his mouth. This is Joe Biden saying that. Tara Reid has a big story about it, about Joe Biden. Every time Joe Biden's on, she's upset. She's very much upset. And I kid you not, this is Joe Biden, everybody, the vice president of Barack Obama, Joe Biden. Tara Reid, I don't know if she's gained traction on social media. But yeah, Tara Reid, young lady goes by the name of Tara Reid, has a story about Joe Biden. This was back in the early 90s. I think she was an intern. They call these people the interns. She was an intern. She was part of the White House interns. I guess they call them interns. But now she is accusing Joe Biden, I'll just say this much, sexual innuendo, maybe. But Joe Biden got on TV, it's like the elephant in the room scenario. He addressed the issue. He said himself, this is Joe Biden coming from his mouth. Nope, he didn't. It's not like he's denying it. He's just saying, nope, it did never happen, never happened. I'm not saying it, Joe Biden's saying it. Tara Reid, if you're out there, I'm just letting you know that Joe Biden was on today. And guess what, Tara Reid? He did not dress the elephant in the room, Tara Reid. I'm not getting on your side, but the story went for you, Tara Reid, that you're accusing Joe Biden, whatever you're accusing Joe Biden of this so-called, this was back in the early 90s. So, I don't know the full story. As people would say, we don't know the full story of Tara Reid. We're going to have to hear it in a here on out. But Joe Biden has said publicly, dress the elephant in the room, which is Tara Reid. One newscast said, have you done so and so forth to Joe Biden? And Joe Biden, on his words, said, nope, I did no such thing. That's his words. That's Joe Biden's words. I didn't say those words in his mouth. Joe Biden did. So, Tara Reid, if you're out there, lady, that's what Joe Biden said. Okay? So, if you hear me, that's what Joe Biden said. I'm not taking sides here, folks. I'm not taking sides. I'm not taking sides of Tara Reid or Joe Biden. All I'm doing is you got to know the full story. People would say on radio stations and TV stations, you got to know the first full story before you get involved in such a thing. But there's been news outlets about her story, about Tara Reid's story. Now, her mother was on the Larry King show back in the early 90s. I don't know if you can see the footage, where the footage is, but was on Larry King's TV show. It was the mother of Tara Reid. So folks, there you go, folks. Protesting is going around the world. Protesting about Black Lives Matter to All Lives Matter. And I'm saying to all this, all lives matter. Not just black people, all lives matter. Every one of us in the world, all lives matter. So it's not just the black people, it's everyday people. Everyday people. So folks, we're just saying it's not the black people's fault that they get the short end of the sticks. It's everybody. Everybody. So it's all lives matter. Not black lives matter. It's all people matter. You don't want to single out everybody. It's not always the black people. It's everybody lives matter. Okay? So I'm going to put that in the hashtag as well. So, folks, bear with me. Tara Reid has a good story, no question about it, but we don't know the full story until Tara Reid or Joe Biden airs out the differences. It's like the elephant in the room, they would say. You know, what's the true story? What's the full story? I want to hear the full story of Tara Reid saying to Joe Biden, did you do this? Kind of thing. This is Tara Reid. She was that young lady. She came out of the world, I think she had to recollect. How do you say in women terms? Recollect from back then. She asked her next door neighbor. Now her next door neighbor went on a TV program called Democracy Now. Don't forget, it's called Democracy Now. The next door neighbor was on TV on Democracy Now, and told her side of the story, because Tara Reid asked the person next door to be on TV. And she was on the Democracy Now. And yeah. So anyway, is it a true story? I don't know. That's my guess. I don't know if it's a true story. We have to hear the full story from her, from Tara Reid. I don't know. Folks, that's all I have to say about that one. I'm not taking both sides. I'm not taking Tara Reid's side. I'm not taking Joe Biden's side. They said what they need to say. It's not like, I'm kind of like the elephant in the room. I'm trying to deal with this elephant in the room. Is it Tara Reid's story that's liable? Or is it Joe Biden that really, really saying, nope, didn't do such a thing? And I always say to people, is there proof of this? Is there photos, videos? Did it happen? Did it, you know, in this day and age, we're kind of like under this umbrella that photos and videos need to be seen to have that evidence, as they would say in the world today. Did this thing actually happen? Did she have photos of this? Did she have video footage of this? We don't know. It's like hearsay. At this point, Tara Reid is only doing the hearsay. She's only saying what she needs to say about the story. But that's that level. She hasn't got proof. Does this thing actually happen? It's like they say in the court system. If you ever go through a court system, they need everything. They need everything in a court system. You get your lawyer. You get everything that you hand it to the lawyer. They're going to go over through everything. Everything. Video, photos, you name it. And a court system. I think that's what they do nowadays. But so they want to know, they want to just read on two people. So you get your lawyers, you get your, Terry will get her lawyers, Joe Biden will get his lawyers, and they'll take it to the court system. We don't want to do that, so they do outside of the court systems. So yeah, but it hasn't reached that point yet. It's just hearsay. Joe Biden says his on national TV. Tara Reid, on the other hand, this is a young woman. She's been in this world for many, many years, and she has a libel story about Joe Biden, Senator, Vice President Joe Biden. And at this point, folks, we don't know.